The next item of business is consideration of business motion 12864 in the name of George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau on changes to the business programme. Any member who wishes to speak against the motion should press their request to speak button now. And I call on George Adam to move the motion.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I'm moved.
Thank you, Minister. And I call on Megan Gallagher to speak to and move amendment 12864.1, up to 5 minutes.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. The Cash Review, published last week, raises serious concerns over gender-affirming care for children in Scotland. Not only does the report conclude that evidence is lacking to support the use of puberty-suppressing hormones, but also details that children and young people may not be offered the right psychological support and assessments when experiencing gender distress. This should worry us all. It certainly worries me as a parent, who would never wish any harm to come to any child, especially ones who need support when going through difficult times in their lives. But the truth is, we don't know what the harms are when it comes to gender care, because further research is needed here in Scotland. I have repeatedly warned this government about the Sandyford Clinic. I have previously asked for a review, similar to the Cash Review, to look at children and young people's gender-related services. I have warned about the lack of evidence in relation to puberty blockers. These calls have been ignored time and time again. And I don't raise these issues to cause problems. I do it because I want to make sure that children receive the right safeguards when embarking on medication that could have life-altering consequences later on. We now have a report that suggests that we approach gender care with caution. Yet we have a Scottish Government burying its head in the sand and refusing to give any indication as to whether they will accept any of the 32 recommendations or, at the very least, pause puberty blockers until we have more evidence that they are safe to use. The Scottish Government must implement the 32 recommendations now or explain why they are not going to do it if that may be the case. It's not as though this Government or Parliament has been starved of opportunities for scrutiny. I have requested ministerial statements, written to the First Minister, submitted a First Minister's question, submitted a topical question, and today an urgent question, each on the CAS review. But all of them either not taken, refused by this Government, or ignored. What more must an elected member do to try and get some answers? Yeah. Our Parliament's principles are openness, accountability, the sharing of power and equal opportunities. Yet we've got a government in hiding, unwilling to address a serious issue in this chamber. I stand here today for the countless parents, carers, young people and those who have been failed by gender-affirming care in Scotland who want and deserve answers. That's all they want. They want confirmation from this government over what they're going to do now that the CAS report has been published in full. The SNP Government has had 2 years since the interim report to think about this, but I now believe that they have done nothing, hoping the issue will go away and no one will dare challenge it. So the Scottish Conservatives are amending the business motion today. If the SNP stand with the principles of this Parliament, they should allow for a ministerial statement on the cash review. Otherwise, it will confirm my suspicion that they are trying to dodge any scrutiny and therefore letting down vulnerable children and young people right across Scotland. I move the amendment in my name.
Thank you, and I call on George Adam to respond, up to 5 minutes, Minister.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I'd like to start with an important part of what Dr. Hilary Cass actually said when she highlights the increasingly toxic ideology and polarised public debate does nothing to serve young people accessing this care, their families and the NHS staff working to care for them. And I believe this is something we should really take and be aware of when we have these discussions. Now, the CAS review, Presiding Officer, is undoubtedly an important, and the Scottish Government has consistently been clear that the review's final reports and findings will closely be considered by both the Scottish Government, the Health Board and wider partners. In the context of how much healthcare can be best delivered in Scotland, as this 400-page considered report was only published last Wednesday, that will, of course, take some time. We are also clear that much of the report is to do with clinical decisions, and those are rightly made by clinicians and not politicians. However, the main point the Chamber is of course aware of is that the cash review was into services in NHS England, not Scotland. Therefore, it is clearly not the responsibility of the Scottish Government to respond to that, but for the UK Government to respond with its ideas for their NHS.
Thank you. And the question is that Amendment 12864.1 in the name of Megan Gallagher, which seeks to amend Motion 12864 in the name of George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau on changes to the business programme, be agreed. Are we all agreed?
No.
The Parliament is not agreed, therefore we'll move to vote and there'll be a short suspension to allow members to access the digital voting system.